Hello and welcome back to the Fallen Tree. Today we're going to be taking out a couple stumps. I'm going to show you the easy way to do it with the tractor that's going to put the least amount of stress on it. I removed a lot of stumps from little ones like this one here that we're going to be doing today to big ones like this. Now today I'm going to use a compact tractor. It's a 25 horse tractor. Pretty much small as you can get for, you know, a compact tractor. It does have a bigger frame. I'm using an LS M225 tractor with a backhoe attachment on it. And the key here, guys, is these hydraulic cylinders and the hoses, not putting too much pressure. A lot of people will try to dig up stumps with their tractor and they'll bend these hydraulic cylinders, which isn't cheap to replace or possibly get rebuilt. I've had this tractor for 5 years now, been able to do it successfully over a dozen times, including that big stump that I showed you just a few minutes ago. So this is a stump we're going to start with. And the key here, guys, is to start away from the stump and work your way in. And not try to take off big bites at a time. You want to break your roots farther out where they're smaller and thinner. Every once in a while you have to get in there with a chainsaw and cut one. But if you start close to the stump, as you'll see, your roots are real thick. But if you work your way out from like 5-6 foot out and you just start digging down and then you work your way in with the dirt, you'll have a better and easier time pulling these stumps. And it won't quite have as much stress on your tractor. And that's the key. We spend a lot of money buying these tractors. We want to take care of them. So let me show you how I do it. And if any of you guys are new to the channel, please click subscribe, like, share. I also got a nice series going on building an off-grid cabin that I've been working on for better part of a year now. I mill all my own lumber with a sawmill up on the hill over here. Cut down the trees, mill them. But let's get back to pulling this stump. Now, as you can see, I'm starting to dig about 6 foot away from this stump. Now, if you've used the backhoe before, you can tell when it's having a little bit of struggles and you can kind of feel it. So if you feel that it's starting to catch and grab and a little bit, don't be afraid to let up on it. Now this root here, you can see I started way out here and had to find a thinner spot to break the root. I worked my way out on that one. So we continue digging all the way around the stump, starting 6 foot out, working our way in, and I try to get underneath just a little bit. As you can see, I'm trying to dig out under the stump as well as I'm doing it. But as I said before, you want to use the least amount of resistance on your tractor. So as you feel you're hitting a hard spot, you might want to just let off on that spot a little bit and maybe go back a couple inches and take a bite or out a little bit. And eventually you'll find that as you dig out these roots, you'll find the thinner spots that will break without breaking your tractor. So here we've got this one almost dug out. Okay. So if you look, I've got this stump dug all the way around. Got dug a little bit deeper than I think it is. I try to undercut it as much as I can with my tractor. Now I'm starting to see some movement. So the next thing we do, I did see the stump starting to move. So we're going to give it a little twist and it should pop right out of there. I might have to reposition the tractor to get on that root right there because it's sticking out the farthest. But I might be able to grab that root right there and twist it. So you have these roots that go straight out from the tree. Every once in a while, you got like a tap root that goes straight down. And that's why I'm using this twisting method, because if I reach out to some of the farthest points on this root, it will twist and pop right out of there. So let's give it a try, and I'll show you what I'm talking about. Instead of trying to get underneath it and lift the whole stump, which is going to put a lot of pressure on your tractor, we're going to make it so it's the easiest on the tractor. We're just going to give it a twisting motion, and that will kind of, the leverage from being far out will sit there and help, and you'll be using less power from your tractor and more from the stump itself. Okay, so I'm going to reach out at the edge here and try to give it a twisting motion. That one seems to be lifting up pretty good. I'll go to the other side, try to twist it that way a little bit. And this one popped right out. It only had roots going sideways on it. So I will show another one that was right next to this one that I dug out. It's got a few more roots to show you what I'm talking about with twisting it out. But first I'll show you how I finish it off. I'll turn it over, clean off the bottom, get as much of the dirt and the clay to stay in the hole before I pick it up and dispose of it. Okay, there it is. We pulled the stump, filled in the hole in less than an hour. It took me about 50 minutes total. About 35, 40 minutes to pull the stump. Now, it wasn't that big of one, but the same process with big ones. Sometimes it just takes a little bit longer. You got a lot bigger roots. Might have to start out a little bit farther. But what you're doing is you're looking for where the roots are small and you're working your way in and slowly undermining the big root. If you get the big roots undermined, you can trim those with a chainsaw or some sort of saw if they get too big, and just keep undermining. And eventually you'll be able to twist that stump right out of there. Now here's that second stump I was telling you about. You'll see it's a little bit bigger. It took me a little bit longer to dig it out. But I did the same process. Started out far away, worked my way in. That way I break the littler roots and just keep working my way in towards it. You can see we dig deep. That way when we undermine it, the dirt falls back into the hole and you have enough room. Now, as you see, we're taking this one the same way. We're twisting it out of there. Grabbed a corner. And because we did all that work going around it and digging deep, it popped right out of there as soon as we used the leverage. So we'll pull that out, clean it up, get rid of it. And that's how easy it is to remove a stump with a compact tractor and a backhoe. as long as you take your time and you feel what the tractor's feeling as it's digging. So if you like this tutorial of how I remove the stumps, please click subscribe, like, share with your friends. And you can check out more videos on my channel at The Fallen Tree, at Fallen Tree 124. Thanks. Until next time, my friends.